Hello, officers. Welcome back to another episode of This is the Police 2. It is our final day of competition with Carter, and we are in a good lead. But Lily has suddenly jumped on board with Carter and given him some sort of files of people who he can arrest. And they are ganging up on us pretty hard. So hopefully we are able to win the competition either way. Borodka didn't come to work today. And neither did Stockman. And Percy is drunk. What? Sullivan, I have a terrible fungus growing on my legs. My foot is swollen, my toes are petrified, and it's beginning to fester. Can I take the day off to get some medical treatment? I would really like to say no, but I think this could maybe kill him at some point. Maybe. Let's ask him about the fungus. My friends have always invited me to winter nights, and I finally agreed. But while I was there, I accidentally knocked over a bucket of dirty water in the bathhouse, and it got all over my legs. That's when the whole thing started. Okay, you can go get some medical treatment, goddammit. We only have, eight officers on today's shift. And once again, the tasers are not going where I want them to go. And that is like they're not going anywhere. Percy is drunk. Maybe Naki could take one, and also Valentin. Okay. So, this day might be a make or break deal. Let's see the food. Macaroni and cheese. Today my grandmother baked my favorite pastry from my childhood. It's too bad the old lady has lost her mind. For some reason she added chocolate to the pastry. She spoiled my favorite childhood memory. That doesn't tell me much. Okay, Spurlock will eat anything. I was looking at photos of me as a kid and remembering how the boys and me cooked baked beans over the open fire. I swear I could smell it. Cherry compote. I choked so bad I almost died. I can't look at cherries right now. Okay, no cherries? Last night I cleared the snow out from under the house and I was sweating all over, even though it was freezing cold out. But today I woke up with a stuffy nose. I would love to have a bowl of something nice hot, some nice hot onion soup. It would make me feel a lot better. Right. So, macaroni and cheese. Let's pick the onion soup for starters. Then let's give the guys some... Where was the mac and cheese? There. And then no cherries. What was the thing about the pastry? She added chocolate, so Woolback doesn't like chocolate. And someone didn't want any cherries. So... Okay, donuts. And let's give them some orange juice today. I think this is okay. We're going only 96 over the budget. So that's fine. Mystery of the black box. The one we failed, so we need to find more frames on that hooded figure. But not today. Not today. This is an important day for us. We need to do well on the streets in order to beat Carter. Right, so we will not be doing any of this stuff. We are focusing...
534 in progress.
Who's this? Horse Moon. 2 months ago I had a terrible nightmare. I was little mouse and I was being chased by a black eagle with blazing eyes. He got up to me and tore me to pieces, and I swear when I woke up I was all scratched. I don't know how to explain it. My cat, Nostradamus, would never do anything like that. Anyway, I felt really awful and asked Sheriff Wells to grant me an extended leave. He promised I could return any time, and well, here I am. I've got to pay the mortgage somehow. That Sheriff Wells had a heart of gold. Nobody can ever replace him. Great, so we got some reinforcement.
548 in progress.
We have a child abuse and also a missing person case. The child abuse is happening at the Beauty and the Beast hair salon. A young son of a hairdresser couldn't sit still and was preventing his mother from working. At first, she yelled at him for a long time, but when this didn't work, the woman grabbed the hot curling iron and burned the boy's hand. God damn it, that's not nice. No, not Spurlock. Let's send in Woolback and Percy as a reinforcement. What? Good lord, Galen Woolback always smells like shit, but today it's just too fucking much. Luke Nash, you can do whatever you want, but I'm not going anywhere in a car with him. Woolback is not smelly, you are smelly, you drunk. And a missing person. At the same place. An elderly man claims that his wife disappeared right from the hairdresser's. I swear, just 5 minutes ago she was sitting there in an armchair and now she's nowhere to be found. Those scissor-carrying witches must have done something terrible with her. This is a false alarm. This has to be. I'll just let it hang there a bit. Let's see if we get anything more important like this car checking. A man in a raincoat ran up to a motorcyclist at the stoplight, pushed him onto the asphalt and stole his bike. Okay, so this is a real job. Kurosawa, will Spurlock go with someone like Valentin maybe? Well, of course not. I guess she won't go with Nakip. Yeah. How about... Okay. I think this combo... Actually, let's send in Valentin. Yeah, this is just perfect. New menu from Julia Kohat. I heard that you've been working hard at your job, and it can hardly be considered real police work. What? What do you mean? The lunch menus are a mess, right? You can never please everybody. I understand your difficulties well. I myself work in the service sector. But more than that, I can help you. My cafe will take care of everything regarding the preparation and delivery of food for all your subordinates. You only need to write a check, and you can forget about people leaving food on their plates. Does that sound appetizing? Well, no, if it's gonna cost me 12,000. No!
526 in progress.
A boy with a burned palm is sitting in the corner crying. His mother is quietly curling the hair of an elderly client. Hit the woman with the shocker, restrain the woman, give the boy first aid. I think first aid might require intelligence, so Woolback will be giving first aid. Or should we just immediately restrain the woman? Actually, that might be a thing. Let's restrain the woman. The cop overpowered and arrested the woman. The boy will be taken by social services. Great. Fletcher. Full stealth. Fletcher has become a ninja. Before raising the alarm, the policeman gets one more action. Up to 3 actions maximum. Alrighty then. Ooh, Woolback. You will be getting some... speed. And Miradian will be getting intelligence. So I really hope this was false alarm. Yes! Eddie McCrean suffers from dementia and forgets that his wife passed away 5 years ago. He often wanders the town looking for her. His granddaughter is taking the elderly man home. Great! Our intuition was correct.
565 in progress.
Drug use and attempted murder. Attempted murder was at the Astrid E. Johnson's high school. A schoolboy borrowed his father's crossbow and ambushed a rival classmate after school. He's hunting him down right there in the schoolyard. Ooh, 1800. Can we do this? Oh, no, we cannot. Or maybe we... Oh, no. No, this is not enough. Are we going to have a dead civilian on our hands? What's this drug abuse? No, drug use. An elderly woman claims that her grandson is skipping class and going to an abandoned boarding house where he smokes marijuana. There's no getting through to him. Maybe once he's behind bars, someone will at least be able to talk some sense into him. Okay, so this is not a real case. Can we get anyone back? No. Oh shit, we are going to have a dead civilian. Oh no. The patrol car caught up with the man wearing a raincoat and sunglasses. We could order him to stop. Kurosawa, order him. Yes! Okay, so he just gave up. Great. Good job, Kurosawa. Oh no!
534 in progress.
I really don't like this, but there's nothing that we can do. Oh shit, do we have a dead kid? Yep. God damn it. Another child abuse. Another attempted murder. Attempted murder at Jameson Hill. A young man mowed the lawn outside Mr. Barlow's house, but the owner decided that the guy did a poor job and refused to pay. Then the guy switched on the lawnmower and started chasing Mr. Barlow around the lawn. Can you die of that? Let's see the child abuse. At the grocery store, an elderly cleaning lady is beating up a boy for riding around on a skateboard. I think we need to do this first. Oh, just enough. And this only requires 770, so I think we can do that. Who else? Percy? Mr. Nash, I'm tired as a dog. I need some rest. God damn it! Nakib? Muradian? Actually, maybe Valentin Muradian? Okay. Hopefully this drug use was also a false alarm. I think it was. Yes, it was. The boy really was a truant, but he was only smoking ordinary cigarettes, neither of which is actually a crime. Great, our intuition is on spot today. I'm happy about that. Okay, we are at the child abuse scene. A fat, elderly cleaning lady is dragging a 10-year-old boy around by the hair and has him pinned up against the wall. The boy is crying while the other customers look on, afraid to interfere. Next to them, on the floor, is a skateboard and a can of peaches. The boy is shopping. Restrain the cleaner. Can we do that? No, we don't have any strength. Come on, kid, what are you crying for? You can take her. Jeez. Use the pepper spray. Who has pepper spray? Is this pepper spray?
534,
the cop sprays the can at the cleaner. The cleaning woman grabs her face and becomes easy prey for the police. The boy's nose is broken, his hair is torn, and he also got hit by the pepper spray, but he'll be fine. Great. And we found some peaches. Valentin will be getting strength. Horse Moon, you get speed. Yeah, the attempted murder. The guy pushing the roaring lawnmower is chasing after the short-legged Mr. Barlow. Shoot the mower, push you the mower. Hey man, you missed a spot. Oh no. Do we have speed? No, not really. We have shooting, so maybe we'll shoot the mower.
526 complete.
The cop shot the lawnmower. It exploded and its operator was killed by the shrapnel. Mr. Barlow is now safe. Okay, but everything went pretty good. Didn't mean to kill the guy, but... For the dogs, Rosaline Whiteside. Mr. Nash, a pipe broke in our animal shelter, Eichthurnir. And now the whole room is flooded. We have taken most of the animals home with us, but we just don't have room for the big dogs. Please, could you shelter them for a day in the cells at your station? The empty ones, of course. While we figure out how to deal with the flood. Please don't refuse, or I'm afraid these animals will literally freeze in the streets. We can offer you antibiotics for your kindness. We can keep them on hand in case someone gets bitten. Okay. That is going to hurt us in some way, I know it, but we don't want the dogs to freeze to death. We are animal lovers here. Okay, the day is almost done and we only have one dead civilian. Should we now do something with these? Seems like nothing else is really happening. The strip club, what do we need? I know that he likes to hang out at the strip club, but it'll be easy to frighten him off. Send him one of your sneakier cops, so you can sneak up on the bastard. And don't forget the pepper spray. Okay, it's not enough to just beat the rapist up. I want him to cry like his victims. Alright, so we would get some intelligence training out of this, because this guy says that I'll teach your cops everything I know. You need smart guys in the service, right? Okay, so let's send in Fletcher. He's stealthy. Does he have pepper spray? I believe so. Okay, I think we can do that. Hopefully nothing major is going to happen now. It's 11. Can we do something else also? I'll wait until 12. Okay, now let's see what we can do. This is some pickpocket guy. Let's see. Send a cop to visit him who is good at hand-to-hand combat and tell him to bring a baton. Do we have any strength guys here? Strength but no baton. Okay, we don't have dudes for that. And what do you want? I can't retire yet, so I need some kind of distraction at work. If you find a small portable TV for me. Portable TV. Do we have that? You don't have everything in the warehouse. No. Okay. And this lady wanted those. Yeah, intelligent people. We have Woolpack. Any other intelligent dudes? Muradian is quite intelligent. So let's send in those two. And the day is over. Great, let's see what happened at the strip club. Mr. Nash, I easily snuck up on that scoundrel and punished him with a can of pepper spray. He was sobbing like a wet rag, begged forgiveness, swore he wouldn't hurt anybody else, but I wouldn't believe him. The clerk was satisfied though. He said that at least some justice had been done and asked me to tell you that he was waiting to give our guys a lesson, even the slow ones. Alright, we got some audio cassettes with music and a cassette player and 300. Great. So let's see what happens at the... What was that? Yeah, we are sending our not-so-dumb dudes to do something. The lock they had on the warehouse was child's play. We got in there, no problem, and grabbed all the furry colas we could find. We might have had a bottle or two in the process, but who's gonna care, right? It's a magical drink after all. So that was a success. We got toilet paper, and once again more razors, and 700. Ooh, now we can buy from Anna. What does she sell? Coffee. Okay, paprika. Someone wanted paprika and cocaine, and I believe it was coffee. I believe that was the case. There's a portable TV set also. All right. So we need to remember to stop by Anna's store tomorrow to buy all the stuff that we need. We have some extra cash. All right, let's see what happens in our competition with Carter. I'm somewhat afraid. How much do we lose? We only got 8. Oh shit! Did we lose? Did we actually lose the whole thing? What happens now? He bought Jacobs. He's also buying all the stuff. And we don't have enough money for, or enough tabs for any new cops. And we cannot get any items because Carter bought everything. Oh shit. What happens now? We lost by 3. Is this game over? No? What is this? Oh Jesus Christ. Flower Pots, Stockman, Maguire, Porodka, Aranovic, Shinny, Spurlock. Oh yeah. Horse Moon, Kurosawa, Sullivan. Should we take Percy? Let's take Percy as well. Okay, 10. That's great. Do we get a cutscene? We do. Does the game end here? Hopefully not. Open the door.
What? I forgot to give you your parking pass?
I have my pass.
Didn't Jesus tell you not to drink?
That's right. I don't drink. I already went through that ordeal, but you... no. Well, it's nothing to be ashamed of.
Oh, I'm not ashamed. You can be sure of that.
Is he going to gloat on his victory?
You know, it's hard to handle some things alone. And sometimes help comes from somewhere you wouldn't expect.
You can say that again.
When I needed help, it was an old man named Tarek Palm, former pastor. They say he was kicked out of the church because he went crazy. I don't know the whole story. Maybe he lost his mind, but he sure didn't lose his instincts. He immediately saw the two things that were ruining my life, lies and stubbornness. So he locked me in the basement.
Lost his mind? Must have been a smart guy.
He locked me up in the basement with the Bible, the Quran, and the Torah. And he told me that he didn't care what I was going to believe, but every righteous man, whatever he believed, had to go through these three steps. Now, the first step is when you choose principles over honesty. And the second step is when you choose honesty over principles. And the third is when you don't need to choose at all, because honesty is your only principle. Now, old man Palm said that he would bring me water every morning and ask, "What stage are you on, son?" 3 weeks later, I answered, "On the third, father." And he let me go. I was a changed man. But I lied about the third stage. I was still stuck on the second one.
Well, I guess that makes you a cheat. And I'm not going to play cards with you. Don't even ask.
The competition between us, maybe it was stupid, but...
It was only stupid when you won it.
I cheated, Jack.
At least he's honest.
I won because Lily helped me. Brought me a pile of papers with lots of leads. And somehow, this one was stuck in with the other papers. Of course, I was going to phone it in right then and there. But then I thought, what will happen if I call? The feds will arrest you. But what then? Would that be the end of it? No, of course not. There'll be reporters, there'll be some kind of investigation, and everyone will be on the hook. Lily, the other cops, our ordinary townspeople, everyone. It's hard to imagine how this would hit our town. Jack, I'm sure you understand. Lily wanted me to take things over gradually, so we could work together for a few days and keep everything calm, right? But you could keep things even calmer. You can leave early in the morning. You can disappear, and no one else in Sharpwood will ever hear from you. It'll be like you were never here, like you got off the bus, you took one breath of icy air, and immediately decided you needed to get out of here. I mean, after all, who would hide from justice in a freezer?
So I wonder if...
Don't be ashamed, Jack. Drink up. You haven't got through this yet. I have.
Yeah, I wonder if that was always going to happen. That we were always going to lose to Carter. It kinda seems so. Which is kinda weird. Like, forcing the competition on us when the end result will always be the same. I don't know if that's the case.
I need to talk to Liam Henderson. I know, but it's important. Yes, I'll hold.
Who was Liam Henderson? I really don't remember. Okay. So it seems that the game did not end there. That was the one thing I was afraid of, that if we lose to Carter, then that's a game over and we would need to go back a few days to try to win it. But it seems that the story still continues. And I have a strong feeling that we could never win with Carter. That is a fixed story point. But okay. I think we have a decent shift coming into work tomorrow. So maybe we'll get the chance to continue with the investigations. And also with those brown missions as well. Because now we got the new store and we can finally buy some paprika and maybe coffee or something like that. And a TV set, stuff like this. But for now, thanks for joining me, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.